Hello viewers, my name is Jackie Dresser with the Efficient Vineyard Project and the Lake Erie Regional Grape Program. It's my pleasure to introduce to you today Zach Harmer. He's from Soil Optix, a company that's changing the way we look at agricultural soils. Zach, can you tell us a little bit about Soil Optix, where it came from, where it's going as a company?
Yeah, so Soil Optix is a Ontario-based company. We started Soil Optix in 2017. Our predecessor company, Practical Precision, started in the early 2010-11 era. We brought our sensor here over from Holland. That is where this technology really started, as a geological-based measurement tool in kind of the mining industry as an airborne mapping system. Through research or through the University of Groningen, they started looking at it as an application for agriculture and modeling fertility essentially and physical properties. And with that, we brought it over to Canada in the early, around 2012, and began doing our research and figuring out how can we westernize this essentially. And ever since then, we've been developing our algorithms to essentially model these fertility and physical properties. And allowing it to be commercially available for farmers to purchase as a service. So
that's great, thank you. So we'll get a little bit into the theory of operation. So can you tell us what the heck is gamma radiation and why do we care about it from an agricultural standpoint?
Sure, so gamma radiation is it's a natural process that's always being emitted from any form of physical properties. So if it's gravel like what we're standing on here today, to the wonderful grass, you know, around your backyard, to of course the soil that's in our agricultural fields. It's always emitting some form of radiation. And this radiation is indicative of course, the geology of that soil as well. So where is it coming from? So here, of course, on the bench, there's a lot of historical, you know, geological processes, right? A lot of different types of soils that this sensor is basically able to pick up on at this very high resolution stage. So, but gamma radiation versus some other soil mapping technologies as well is very stable. So it's something that's very repeatable on a year-to-year basis. So a survey can last you 6 to 8 years if need be. And it's also its relation to, of course, the physical properties, so clay, sand, silt, organic matter, CEC, but also it has a relationship to some of the nutrients or fertility models that we developed and continue to develop through research as well. So calcium, magnesium, potassium, phosphorus, pH, or organic matter being a physical property, of course, and as well as some of the micronutrients too. And then we've also taken it to start deriving complex models. So plant available water, so water retention models, bulk density, and we're even looking into risk for compaction maps, nematode risk maps, those kind of things, just trying to leverage all the data that we can off of this sort of technologies.
Wow, it sounds like it has a lot of different applications.
Yeah.
And if you keep up with our podcasts, you've heard about NDVI and some of the spectral sensing that we do in vineyard canopies. And we kind of use the narrative that the canopies have a unique spectral signature or spectral fingerprint. And those are light rays, visible light rays and near infrared light rays coming off the canopy that we're measuring. So what the Soil Optix sensor is tapping into is the unique gamma footprint, which is also a ray coming out of the soil. And that's actually what we're mapping. So it's another sensor tapping into a little bit different data. And as you can see, it has a really wide range of uses in ag in terms of mapping at a high resolution, you know, the physical properties that are related to fertility. So how do you get from a map of the gamma signature or the gamma radiation into a map of your relative fertility in the specific nutrients that you mentioned?
Sure. So yeah, we do map and survey the ground in broad acre crops, let's say in about 40-foot centers, 12 to 15 miles an hour if we can. In specialty crops, which we're fairly new in. We've done some trial work up in Ontario. We've done some stuff in California as well. And of course here the last couple days, every third row, a little bit slower speed, so we can actually enhance the resolution of the data on these small plots that you find in specialty crops, of course. Our regular resolution would be 11 and a half feet. On our back end, we can actually now probably go even down to 8-foot grids, which obviously is huge for what you do. But on the survey side, you know, that is one piece of the puzzle, right? But how do we get from, you know, that to those fertility models? Well, we have to pull physical samples,
Okay, so I have to go out in my vineyard and take a soil core sample.
Yes,
okay.
You still have to take
Can't get away from that.
No, we'll never be able to get away from soil sampling. So that's what we use to calibrate essentially what we see in the field at those specific points where we pull the sample to the fertility and the plant available properties that you get from the lab. Okay, and we use a variety of different metrics to really derive those models. So we're looking at four specific isotopes from the sensor. So we have potassium 40, thorium 232, uranium 238, cesium 137, and we also do bring in what's known as count rate, which is that generalized radiation value that we see within our logging software as we're surveying. And then we also bring in, of course, the elevation, which we're collecting real time as well with the GPS. And so all those sort of metrics come into play into our modeling. It can be linear, it can be quadratic, multilinear, but we also bring in, of course, geospatial statistics to have that relative difference throughout the field, of course, and trying to capture as much information as we can and ultimately try to produce as quality a model or a predictive model as possible for those fields. So.
Okay, so basically a Soil Optix service provider comes out, does the survey for you, takes a number of core samples, and you do all the data processing, and what is delivered is a rasterized image, much like our NDVI maps or our yield maps, of your relative fertility in all of the macros and micros that you mentioned, as well as pH.
Yeah, no, for sure. So we, rasterized. Most of our guys will take in shapefiles as well, just more or less just because of the programs that they're using. Mm-hmm. But ultimately, it's a high-resolution image of the field based on a variety of different properties. So if you're chasing potash, or if you're chasing, phosphorus, or even a liming application like you guys have here, that you're trying to chase a lot of, right? You can utilize that high resolution information to ultimately fine tune the application of those products, and try to chase those, let's say, deprived areas of the field, but also trying to optimize location or application, so we're not over applying on areas that may not need it.
Right. So the Soil Optix map become your prescription map or your basis for variable rate nutrition management, whether that's through liming or potash, which is sort of our limiting factors here in the Lake Erie region, but also a large number of other things, probably more important, NPK in your broad acre fields.
Absolutely. Yeah. And then even on a physical property side, you can even start looking at variable rate seeding. Right, you creating management zones maybe based on different varieties, based on, let's say, your clay percentage or your organic percentages, or even into a CEC, right? So trying to open up the opportunities for growers to micromanage their fields more than what they've been able to do in the past.
And maybe for us at Vineyard Establishment, that looks like choosing a different rootstock.
Sure. Yep,
so absolutely. More of a variable rate Vineyard Establishment and taking care of those variability causes up front so that you have a more uniform vineyard over the life of your vineyard.
Absolutely. But. Yeah, that's what we're trying to chase, right? Uniformity, balance in the soil, no matter the crop.
Great.
Right? And that's really what we're trying to chase with utilizing this product amongst the variety of different layers that, research institutions like yourself, growers have, if it's yield, if it's NDVI, trying to just maximize as much as we can into those management decisions.
Fantastic. So where can our viewers find out more about Soil Optix, Zach?
So you can visit our website, soiloptix.com. We're also on Twitter, at Soil Optix. You can contact a variety of different soil or service providers that we have across our network internationally. All on our website, of course, and you can drop us a line or an email through there as well and talk to any one of us at our office there.
Fantastic. So. Thank you, Zach. And as usual, if you have any questions, please post them in the comments below, and we'll see you next time.